Hi, everyone. Welcome. Welcome to the Riverside County Bar Association's installation 2020. This is new for most of us. In fact, for probably all of us. And I'd like to tell you, at least I know there are two things that are for sure going to happen today. Number one, we're going to have technical difficulties. That's just the nature of the game today when we're doing virtual meetings like this, and that's to be expected. And number two, I won't be perfect today. So those are the two things that you can count on, but I am sure that you are going to have an amazing event today, an amazing time. I'd like to say thank you to Sophia Choi and the rest of the Riverside County Bar Association for giving me the honor to be the master of ceremonies today. It is a privilege and an honor, and I thank you very much for that. I also want to thank Charlene Nelson, who's keeping me on track and up to date, and she's done so much work with the bar over the years, and I really do appreciate everything she's done. So let's get started. The first thing I'd like to do is to introduce the judiciary and the dignitaries who are in attendance today on this virtual meeting. The first person, or we'll start with the Court of Appeals, Justice Carol Codrington, Justice Richard T. Fields, Justice Frank Menetrez, Justice Douglas Miller, Justice Michael Raphael. From our Riverside County Superior Court, we have our presiding judge, John Binyard, assistant presiding judge, John Monteroso, Judge Irma Asbury, Judge Thomas Kerriman, Judge Mark Cope, Judge Stephen Cunnison, Judge Kenneth Fernandez, Judge Chad Firetag, Commissioner Candace Garcia Rodrigo, Judge Jennifer Gerard, Judge Carol Green, Commissioner Belinda Handy, Judge Eric Keene, Judge Jack Lucky, Judge Raquel Marquez, Judge Dennis McConaughey, Judge Russell Moore, Judge Cheryl Murphy, Judge Gail O'Rain, Judge Matthew Perantoni, Judge Bernard Schwartz, Judge Shama Shuka, Judge Emma Smith, Judge Randall Stamen, Judge Sunshine Sykes, Judge Gloria Trask. From our San Bernardino Superior Court, we have Judge Corey Lee and Judge Wilfred Schneider. From our Los Angeles Superior Court, we have Judge Ann Park, Judge Susan Jung Townsend. We have other dignitaries in attendance today. We have Steve Harmon, who is our Riverside County Public Defender, Angela Viramontes, who is the Chief Federal Public Defender, Riverside Branch. We have Sheriff Chad Bianco, Riverside County Assistant District Attorney Elena Bentley. We have Riverside County Acting Assistant, well, now he is the Assistant District Attorney for our Admin Division, Jared Herringsma. We have our Eastern Assistant District Attorney, Gerald Kleinman. We have our Chief Deputy District Attorney, Kelly Catlett. Our Chief Deputy District Attorney, Sam Kalusian. Chief Deputy District Attorney, Brandon Smith. Assistant U.S. Attorney for the Chief, and she is the Chief of the Riverside Branch, Shelley Clack. We have the Assistant U.S. Attorney, Jerry Yang, and I apologize, Shelley Clack is the Chief Deputy County Counsel of Riverside. I'm sorry for giving you a promotion or demotion, whichever way you look at that. We have Judge Eric Keene, who is the current president of the Leo A. Deegan Inn of Court. We have Dave Kim, who is the president of Apali. Eugene Kim, who is the president of the San Bernardino County Bar Association. Elizabeth Kim, who is the president of the Korean Prosecutors Association. Supervisor Karen Spiegel, who is the Riverside County Board of Supervisors, Second District Representative. Alti Holcomb, who is a field representative for Senator Richard Roth. George Johnson, who is our executive officer for the Riverside County. We have Juan Perez, who is the director of the TLMA of Riverside County. Carissa Leach, who is the assistant director of TLMA. We have Karen Worcester, chapter relations director of the American Inns of Court. Justine Ross, associate director, UCR's Presley Center of Crime and Justice Studies. We have Rihanna Ashton, principal, Notre Dame High School. And Mark Echeverria, vice chancellor of the Diocese of San Bernardino. And he is the director of Apostolic and Ethnic Affairs. I have one announcement before we move on with our program. As some of you may or may not know, the Honorable Judge J. Thompson Hanks passed away this past Wednesday. I wanted to read a brief tribute to Judge Hanks that was prepared by Elena Bentley, who is the assistant district attorney here in our office. If I may have just a minute, I'd like to read this to you. A true legacy. The Honorable Judge J. Thompson Hanks started in the Riverside County District Attorney's Office on July 1, 1974. The same day as his lifelong friend, the former former colleague, now retired District Attorney Grover Trask. Jay was promoted to Supervising Deputy District Attorney in August of 1981 and to the Assistant District Attorney position in November of 1982. In June of 1988, Jay was elected as the judge of the Riverside County Municipal Court, filling the vacancy left by the retirement of the Honorable Judge George Miller. Jay resigned our office in September of 1988 to assume his new role, where his first jury trial in the municipal court was as a judge on a DUI case featuring then misdemeanor Deputy District Attorney Elena Gambera Bentley. Jay is survived by his wife Kay of 54 years and their two children, Deputy District Attorney Emily Hanks and former Deputy District Attorney and now Private Attorney Joshua Hanks. As the Assistant District Attorney, Jay hired and interviewed many of our former remaining deputy district attorneys and former district attorneys in our office. One of his trademark interview techniques was to ask if the individual played softball. If you played softball, apparently you were in. Of course, he did most of his interviews during the springtime and the winter. So our colleagues may well remember that that was a time to bring people in and have them visit Riverside, Mount Rubidoux, all the other attractions that are here in Riverside County. He was known as a tough judge. His door was always open, though, to anyone who wished to speak to him. He helped me on a number of occasions. He helped a number of us in our office and as well as the defense bar. He earned the respect of almost everyone who entered his courtroom. Jay was born in Beardstown, Illinois, and as a child, he lived in Riverside for a short time until returning to his family in Illinois. Eventually, he settled in Riverside and had started to live here since 1964. He's a graduate of the University of Riverside. He attended law school at Pepperdine University. He is a veteran. He served with the United States Navy as a mine warfare technician and was stationed for much of his service in Yosuka, Japan. Our thoughts and prayers go out to the Hanks family at this time. Now, at this time, I'd like to acknowledge the sponsorships for this great event from the Riverside County Bar Association. And you'll see those names up on the screen in just a second. What's amazing about during this time in the midst of COVID, our sponsors have been extremely generous. They have been so generous that this year's donations have broken and surpassed all past records. To date, the donations include PIP printers discounts. The amount exceeds $25,000. And I'd like to give them acknowledgement and hopefully, I wish we could do virtual applause, but I guess we can't. But I'd like to list their names now. The Diamond sponsors are Altura Credit Union, Bratton, Razzo, and Lord, Dispute Resolution Services Incorporated, Jeffrey H. Hopper and Associates, Girardi and Keith, Riziel Lipinski. Our platinum sponsors include Sophia Choi and Sylvia Choi. Aitken Cone, Best and Krieger, Jams, Reed and Hellier. Our gold sponsor are the Blumenthal Law Offices. Our silver sponsors are Apali, Riverside County Barristers, Chandler Law Firm, Paul Gretsch, Attorney at Law, Gresham, Savage, Nolan, and Tilden, Dr. James Husson, Chris and Cheryl Johnson, the Korean Prosecutors Association, Manufacturers Bank, Richard T. Fields Bar Association, Riverside County Deputy District Attorneys Association, Stream, Kim, Hicks, Rage, Alfaro, Judge Gloria and Gordon Trask, Barner and Brandt, David and Ginger Werner. Our copper sponsors include the Nez Law Group, Judge Russell Moore, Ward and Ward. Our bronze sponsors include Canyon Children's Legal Services, Aaron Chandler, Thomas Chisholm, Judge Stephen Cunnison, Megan Demschke, Judge Richard T. Fields, Commissioner Candice Garcia-Rodrigo, Dan Hentman, Don Inske, Ann Lee, Sandra Lear, Robin and John Lewis, Edward Mackey, Michael Ortiz, Jocelyn Pulliam, Judge Craig and Maria Reamer, Judge Wilfred Schneider, Silver and Wright, Scott Talcuff, Thompson and Colgate, Jeff Van Wagenen, Taylor Warner, and a special recognition to Pitt Printing for their generous printing sponsorship. I'd like to now recognize our past presidents of the Riverside County Bar Association in attendance. 1981, Judge Stephen Cunnison. 1991, excuse me, Judge 1991, Sandra Lear. 1995, Steve Harmon. 1996, Jim Heiding. Pardon me, Heiding. 1997, Judge Irma Asbury. 1999, Presiding Judge John Vineyard. 2007, Dan Hentman. 2011, Robin Lewis. 2013, Jacqueline Carey Wilson. 2014, Judge Chad Firetag. 2016, Judge Simon Serrano. 2017, Alexandra Fong. 2018, Jeff Van Wagenen. I'd like to now call on Sophia Choi for the presentation to the Riverside County Bar Association's outgoing president.
Hi, good afternoon. Sorry there was a delay. There's quite a walk from where the main computer is to this podium. Jack Clark, our outgoing president, is someone that needs no introduction. He's famous. Everyone knows and loves Jack. I wanted to take this opportunity to thank Jack for his dedication and service to the RCBA. It was not an easy year to lead with COVID-19 and its impacts, but he took that as an opportunity to do something for the RCBA and led the renovation of the building. And I'm hearing very positive feedback about the building's new look. Thank you for your leadership and service to the RCBA. And I look forward to continuing to work with you on the RCBA board in your role as immediate past president. As we present him with an award as a token of our gratitude, we would like to call upon Jack for his outgoing presidency remarks. And Jack has already received his award.
Good afternoon, and thank you for those kind words, Sophia. Just a few quick thoughts, some words of thanks. As Sophia noted, obviously it's been a very, very difficult year for us all. In terms of the association, because of the tenacity of the bar administration and this year's outstanding board, excluding their immediate past president, we were able to accomplish some initiatives that I think will be of use to the bar in the future. And so I want to say words of thanks to all of them. And I know Sophia, this year's president, is going to pick up the pace even more. Indeed, she's already begun that process with several matters she's already taken care of. One last thought as I head out the door. I think back, and I've been a member of this association as long as I've been in practice in Riverside, which is now over 30 years. But it was the prodding of David Bristow and now Judge Kira Klatchko, who encouraged me to become a member of the board. And I have to admit that formerly I would simply curse them under my breath, but now I'm eternally in their debt. They've given me an opportunity to engage with an organization that is truly outstanding. I wish this organization the very best in the coming years, and I wish Godspeed to Sophia. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jack. Appreciate your comments. Now I'd like to recognize those RCBA members who have 25 years or more of service. Those members who have been RCBA members for 25 years or more and are in attendance, and these are individuals who have not received their commemorative pins just yet. Pam Bratton, Judge Mark Cope, Eric Garner, Michael Govea, Judge Dennis McConaughey, Judge Gloria Trask. Our recipients can pick up their pins at the RCBA office at their convenience. I'd also like to now recognize those members of the bar who have been members for 50 years or more. These individuals will have plaques sent to them in their honor. Judge Robert Blumenthal, Judge Stephen Cunnison, who is also, who is also a member of RCBA for 50 years. Dale Gibro, Dale Gribo, apologize for that. Don Inske, Stephen Moyer, Joseph Walker. We're now going to have a video played and narrated by Robin Lewis describing the E. Aurora Hughes Meritorious Award for Service and the James H. Krieger Award.
Hi, my name is Robin Lewis. I'm a past president of the Bar Association, and I'm here to talk to you a little bit today about two of the top awards that the Riverside County Bar Association bestows on its members to honor them for service. The first one being the James Krieger Award for Meritorious Service. That award honors people who are attorneys or judges in our legal community who have dedicated themselves to doing community service, to giving back to our community at large. The second award is the E. Aurora Hughes Meritorious Award for Service. And that award, which is given annually, is given to an attorney that the Bar Association feels has devoted themselves to the legal community or the Riverside County Bar Association. So let me talk a little bit about the Krieger Award, and then I'll talk about the E. Aurora Hughes Award. The Krieger Award is named after James Krieger, who was a named partner at Best Best and Krieger. James Krieger was an amazing attorney with an incredible reputation. Everyone who knew him talked about his personality, his charisma, and his legal prowess. He devoted himself to helping other attorneys be the best that they could be. And in fact, there was a term, I understand I wasn't, unfortunately, I didn't have the privilege of knowing Mr. Krieger personally, but the story goes that for anyone who was put under his tutelage, they were Kriegerized. unfortunately, we lost Mr. Krieger in a plane crash in 1975. However, his memory lives on, and his dedication to the Riverside community and giving back to the community still lives on. Mr. Krieger was involved in almost everything. He served on boards and churches and local hospitals. He was very involved in UCR. He was also very, very involved and influential in our political structure and governmental process. Perhaps his greatest legacy, or something that he is most remembered for, is the Monday Morning Group. The Monday Morning Group still lives on here in Riverside. What it does is it's a group of influential local leaders who get together to identify specific and significant issues in our legal community and then try to implement action designed to address those issues. So the group gets together and then after the group discusses whatever issues they've identified, they then try to work with Sacramento to effectuate changes. The award that was given in honor of Mr. Krieger is really designed to recognize lawyers with outstanding records of community service or community achievement. They could be lawyers or judges who are serving or have served in Riverside County and who over their lifetime have accumulated an outstanding record of community service or community achievement. That service may be limited to service to the legal community, but must not be limited to service to the RCBA. So one of the things that the Krieger Committee, which is the committee that decides who is going to be receiving the award, if it is given, it's not an annual award, it's only given if there is a candidate that the committee thinks is worthy enough of having that award bestowed upon them. It really is an award that is designed to honor somebody who does not just devote themselves to the legal community, but to the community at large. The E. Aurora Hughes Award is a little bit different in the sense that it focuses on attorneys that dedicate themselves to the legal community and who dedicate themselves to the Riverside County Bar Association. Aurora Hughes, I was fortunate enough to know personally. When I was a young attorney, when I first came to Riverside, Aurora was one of the few female attorneys that I saw that just was tough and tenacious and didn't let anything stand in her way of being the best attorney that she could be. She also was dedicated to helping young attorneys and to doing everything she could to make the Bar Association a better place for those who practiced in our legal community. Aurora was so involved in the Bar Association. That's actually how I met her. She was involved on the Publications Committee, which puts forth our Riverside Lawyer, which is our magazine. She was involved in the Continuing Education Committee. She served as the chair for the delegate committee that would go up every year and try to have laws passed or to effectuate change in the law. Unfortunately, by the time Aurora became president of the Riverside County Bar Association, she was diagnosed with Lou Gehrig's disease. And that's a death sentence. If you receive a Lou Gehrig's disease diagnosis, or ALS as it's also known, you basically have a limited span of life to expect. You are limited to approximately 3 years. For many, you might just say, I'm not spending the time that I have left serving as president of the Bar Association. You may feel sorry for yourself and wonder, why did this happen to me? But that wasn't Aurora. Aurora continued with her presidency. She served the Bar Association and did it with courage and honor. She never once felt sorry for herself. In fact, she would always say how lucky she was to have the life that she had. And I watched her with her fight with ALS, and she faced it with courage. And I'm getting choked up now because it was just so amazing. And she touched so many lives. After she passed in 2011, it was decided that the Bar Association should have an award in her name to honor those people that dedicate themselves to the legal community. And so Aurora actually received posthumously the first E. Aurora Hughes Award for Meritorious Service. This is an award that is given every year. So far since 2011, Past recipients have included Justice Thomas Hollenhorst, our current public defender, Steve Harmon, Terry Bridges, who is just an icon in the Riverside legal community and Riverside legal history, Judge Becky Dugan, and this year's recipient is going to be Greg Rizzio, who was a close friend of mine and someone that I am so proud of because he just does so much and just asks, doesn't ask why, just says, what can I do? And so I can't think of anyone better to receive this award this year. Those are the awards that are given. I was fortunate enough to receive the award myself in 2018. But I can't imagine anyone being more deserving of that award than Aurora, and I'm so proud that that award is named after her. Thank you.
Thank you, Robin. So here to present the E. Aurora Hughes Meritorious Award for Service is Robin Lewis. Robin, I'm sorry, you're on mute.
Okay.
Perfect.
All right. Everybody can hear me? I was just saying, I feel like I am so technologically illiterate with this Zoom stuff that I feel like my mom with a remote control trying to use a television. Well, anyway, I'm glad everyone can hear me. I'd like to wish everybody a good afternoon. It's such an honor that I get to speak to you today about my friend, Greg Rizzio, this year's recipient of the E. Aurora Hughes Award for Meritorious Service. Before I begin though, I just wanted to extend a personal congratulations to the incoming RCBA Board and the incoming Barristers Board. I particularly want to congratulate my good friend, Sophia Choi, our incoming president. After seeing all that she's accomplished to ensure that the tradition of the Riverside County Bar Association's annual installation still went forward, despite the restrictions of COVID-19, there is no doubt that Sophia is going to be an amazing president during her term this year. And I also briefly wanted to thank Megan Demschke and Aiken Aiken Cohn for all of their hard work and efforts to put forth the technological component of this this installation. Your hard work has not gone unnoticed. So practicing here in Riverside, there are so many people who devote so much of themselves to giving back to the Riverside County Bar Association and to the legal community at large. I was so happy to hear that this year's board had voted unanimously to vote Greg Rizzio, however, as the recipient of the Hughes Award, because I cannot think of any person that is a better candidate. And there are few people who give as much and as selflessly as Greg does. So it took me a while. I wanted to think about what I wanted to say about Greg. The first thing I would say is I'm pretty sure that everybody knows him, right? I am convinced that the man knows everybody in the state of California. Greg is kind, he's generous, he has never-ending energy, he is always positive, he is always happy, and he is truly the most humble person that I have ever met, despite all of his amazing accomplishments. In fact, when I congratulated him on receiving this award, his prompt reply was that he did not feel that he was worthy of receiving it, to which I promptly told him to shut up. In 2011, I was gearing up to become president of the Riverside County Bar Association. I had just had my triplets in 2010, and I was trying to find a balance between my home life and returning to my professional life, but I was also getting ready to be sworn in as president of this great organization. One day I was in my office and my assistant said that Greg Rizzio was on the phone. I knew who he was, but I didn't know him personally. So I was intrigued as to why he was calling me. As soon as I began talking to him, I felt as if we had been friends forever. Greg was calling to introduce himself and to offer any support or assistance that I might need during my presidency. I was so touched by his generosity, and then I actually quickly thought to myself, he has no idea what he just got himself into, because I will for sure take him up on his offer. During that conversation, it also came up that Greg and I are from the great state of New Jersey. Now, for those of you that know nothing about people from New Jersey, I have to explain that we have a huge amount of Jersey pride. Huge. And even if you no longer live in New Jersey, you are still from New Jersey. And when you meet another person from New Jersey, there is an unexplained bond that immediately forms. That is exactly what happened with Greg and I. Our friendship began on that date, and I have been so incredibly blessed to know him and to have had the opportunity to work with him. Greg is just one of those people who is always there for you. Again, you never have to ask him for anything. He is just there offering his support. One of my sons has a lot of health issues and has been in and out of the hospital these last few years. Every time there's been an issue, Greg is the first one to ask, how can he help? Do you need anything at your office? Do you need any appearances covered? And every time I or anyone else has needed to call on his legal expertise and experience, he is willing to share whatever he can to make sure that you are more successful. His generosity is truly unparalleled. As my co-chair, Greg was instrumental in helping me start the New Attorney Academy, which is a program that was originally developed by the Riverside County Bar Association and the Riverside Superior Court. The purpose of the academy is to train new attorneys in our legal community on how to do things like take a deposition or conduct voir dire. Later on, Greg involved the Inland Empire chapter of the American Board of Trial Advocates. So ABOTA is now a third sponsor of our program. From its inception, Greg has been an active member of our steering committee. He's joined me for almost every session of the academy for the last 7 years as an instructor and as a mentor to the new students. And his generosity doesn't stop there. He is responsible for getting almost all of our attorney speakers. I told you he knows everybody in the world. And even volunteers the time of other attorneys and staff members at his firm to make sure that the New Attorney Academy is successful. When asked for his help or assistance, Greg never says no, and he never says why. He just says, what can I do? What do you need? How much do you need? For raising money for a scholarship fund for the late Douglas Weathers, to helping with the fundraising and planning of the memorial service held at the historic courthouse for Judge Woody Rich, Greg has never said no. And he's not just that way with me. He is consistently dedicated to giving 100% from everything to serving on the Riverside County Bar Association's foundation board to participating in the Leo A. Deegan in a court. Let me give you another example of Greg's generosity. We can all agree that today should have been an amazing day for Sophia Choi and her family as we celebrate her installation. And while we are doing that virtually, it's just not the same as it would have been had we all been at the Mission Inn. COVID has really robbed her of that celebration. And although she has been so very gracious, the only thing that she really wanted was for the traditional paper invitations to go out to the membership. But unfortunately, for budgetary reasons, it didn't look like that was gonna happen. I was talking to Greg one day in passing, and we were talking about installation, and I mentioned the invitations in passing. Without skipping a beat, Greg immediately offered to pay for the invitations without even asking. That is the generous spirit that I'm talking about. Now, I haven't even begun to highlight all of Greg's other legal accomplishments. If for some crazy reason you don't know Greg Rizzio, you should know that he is regarded as one of the best and most successful personal injury attorneys in the state of California. Here in Riverside, he secured an almost $58 million plaintiff's verdict, which was the largest plaintiff's verdict ever in Riverside County. In 2014, when he got that verdict, it was the number one verdict in the state of California and the 10th largest verdict nationally. He has received countless awards, including the Litigators Award, which is something that is only given to 1% of the attorneys in the nation. He is a past recipient of the Trial Lawyer of the Year Award from the California Consumer Attorneys, and he's recognized as a Southern California Super Lawyer. He is a life member of the Multi-Million Dollar Advocates Forum, and he received the Trial Lawyer of the Year Award from the San Bernardino County Bar Association. He has also received the Terry Bridges Outstanding Attorney Award from the Leo A. Deegan Inn of Court. I'm sure that I'm missing other awards, but at least that gives you a highlight. When he's not out making millions for his clients or helping me or the Riverside County Bar Association, Greg is also involved in other organizations to ensure the success of lawyers statewide. He serves on the executive board for ABOTA. He has served as the past president of the Consumer Attorneys of the Inland Empire, and he's currently serving as the second vice president for the Consumer Attorneys of California Executive Board. And despite all of that, all of his professional accomplishments and his constant giving back to make our legal community a better place, Greg is a devoted husband and dad to three kids. He's always talking about his family, and it is clear that he is more devoted to them than anything else that he does. So the real question that I had to ask myself as I was preparing my comments was, when does Greg sleep? When does he eat? If you know Greg, he is a constant bundle of energy. He's always on the go, he's always prepared, and he's always ready to serve. He's always ready to give whatever is needed of him. Greg, I am so very honored that you chose me to present this award to you this afternoon. I thank you for your constant friendship and your support. I thank you for everything that you do for the Riverside County Bar Association and for the legal community. I thank you for being an inspiration on how to practice law and how to give back. I wish that I could now personally hand you this award and have everyone stand up and salute you to commend you for all of your accomplishments. But since I'm stuck in this virtual reality, I would ask that if anyone who is watching this presentation right now, if you see Greg, even if you don't know him, go up to him and thank him, because I guarantee you that he has touched your life in some way or another, and you probably don't even realize it. I can think of no better person to receive the E. Aurora Hughes Award for Meritorious Service than you, my friend and my partner in crime. Congratulations, and thank you for all that you do.
Wow. I need to start this off by saying thank you to Robin for the kind words, obviously, but mostly for just her friendship. She was the one that brought me from the outskirts of the RCBA into the RCBA to be involved. I've appreciated her as a fellow Jerseyan, but mostly just as such a great friend and such a great person. I have said this before, I will say this to the day I die. The E. Aurora Hughes Award should be given to Robin Lewis every single year for in perpetuity. Until the day I die, she will earn this award every year. She is that giving. She is a skilled lawyer, a great person, a great mother. Thank you, Robin. While giving out thank yous, I'd like to thank Jack Clark and the outgoing board for presenting me with this honor. And I'd also like to thank them mostly for guiding us through, you know, the year the world stood still. COVID hit, and they just so masterfully guided this organization through that with such skill and humble hearts, and did so much during a difficult time. Congratulations are in order for John Brown. John, the Krieger Meritorious Service Award that you've earned is a well-earned recognition and achievement, and I congratulate you for that. I'd like to congratulate the Riverside County Barrister Board for their incoming installation. I know so many of you through the Riverside County, New Lawyers Academy, and I'm just so proud of you. And I know Robin is too. You guys have stood up and you've stepped into the leadership roles that you were born to be in. And this organization in the future is in such great hands because of you guys stepping up and being leaders at a young age, something I really wish that I had done. Speaking of being in great hands, congratulations to Sophia Choi and her board. I am so excited. I see greatness in this board. I think this board is going to do an amazing job. It will start off difficult, but they will guide us through and they will get us back to where we were before the pandemic. And I'm just super proud of you guys. And if I'm a phone call or a text away if you need anything. It's humbling to receive this award. I think the best way to do that is to talk about how Presiding Justice Ramirez described it. In 2013, he said, with a little paraphrasing, "If the recipients of any award given in her name are expected to measure up to her standards and her commitment to this community and this bar association, then those in consideration will have their work cut out for them to live up to the standards and examples that she sets." Robin went through a lot of the past winners, but the names are just pillars of this society, of this community. Aurora herself, Dan Hantman, Justice Hollenhorst, Brian Piercy, our current Riverside County Public Defender, Steve Harmon, Terry Bridges, who did a very classy thing and gave this award to Charlene Nelson, who obviously is so instrumental to this organization. And Charlene, I don't say it enough, I love you. Anything you need, I'm a phone call away. Judge Trask, obviously Robin, who I can't thank enough for all that she does for me and for this organization and this community, and Judge Dugan. it's humbling to have my name associated with those names. And frankly, I don't think it belongs there. I think I would like to end this with a promise to you all. James Heiding, a past Riverside County Bar Association president and a friend and a great, great lawyer and a great, great person, said this about Aurora when he was describing her at her funeral. Aurora Hughes found her satisfaction, her feeling of success in life, in the service, in the area of service. In every aspect of her life that I ever saw, she was oriented toward service. If she saw something that you could use to succeed or be better, she would give it to you. She would give of herself. Even at the end, she continued to give us her most precious possession, her time. Again, I don't really feel that my name belongs in the pillars here of with the others. They've done so much more. They deserve it so much more. The promise I give to you all is I will live every day to honor her, to honor her name, to honor this award, and to try and make the other recipients of this award proud to see my name there with them, because it doesn't belong there yet, but I hope someday it will. Thank you.
Greg, very well deserved. Congratulations on the E. Aurora Hughes Meritorious Awards for Service. Definitely well deserved. I find this whole virtual reality setup interesting and unnerving, because after those speeches from Robin and from Greg, you'd probably hear thunderous applause and joy. Now that it's so quiet, I'm sitting up here in my office and I can, you know, and maybe COVID, right? But it's too bad, because you definitely deserve it. So next, I'd like to invite Eric Garner to introduce the James H. Krieger Award.
Thank you, John. And thanks to everyone involved with this program for allowing me to be part of it today. It's going very smoothly despite the technological challenges. Well, it's a privilege and an honor to be asked to present the James H. Krieger Meritorious Service Award to John Brown. John practiced law at Best Best and Krieger for 45 years, focusing his practice on representing cities and public agencies and providing them with superlative legal representation. And in recognition of that representation, last year, John was chosen the Public Lawyer of the Year in California by the California Lawyers Association. You know, next year, Best Best and Krieger will celebrate its 130th year. And over that century and a third, there's a short list of attorneys who've dramatically impacted the direction of Best Best and Krieger. One is certainly James Krieger, and one is certainly John Brown. However, despite John's remarkable legal practice, when asked what he is most proud of, John always first points to his history of community service. And that's why I think we all agree he's extremely deserving of the Krieger Meritorious Service Award. It's not an award given every year, as Robin mentioned. It's been given to a select few Riverside County Bar Association members who've demonstrated a lifetime of service to the community. It honors Jim Krieger's memory and his exceptional record of service to the community. Now, it's also an award with great personal meaning to John, because Jim Krieger personally inspired John to give back to the community in meaningful ways. When John first started at BBK in 1975, he met Jim Krieger. It wasn't long after that that Jim tragically was killed. But during that short period of time, he made a very strong impression on John, and that inspired John throughout his career. In preparation for this event today, I reread Terry Bridges' 2014 remembrance of Jim Krieger in the Bar magazine. I would highly recommend that, because from reading that, it's easy to see why John was so inspired by Jim. You know, and along with other BBK partners like Art Littleworth and Bill DeWolf, Dallas Holmes and Dick Anderson, Jim Krieger instilled in John the belief that giving back to the communities in which you live and also work is important. And that's something John carried forward throughout his entire career. Shortly after joining BBK, a couple partners asked John to join the community-wide effort to save the Mission Inn through the formation of the Mission Inn Foundation. He later served as president of the Mission Inn Board of Directors for two terms. He headed up the foundation's efforts to restore the lost artifacts through its Bring It Home campaign. And for those, when you visit the inn and you see those things, many of them are there because of John's efforts. John's dedication to the Riverside community continued through his work on the boards of the Riverside Art Museum, the Riverside Downtown Partnership, and the Riverside Public Library Foundation. He eventually served as chair to both the Downtown Partnership and the Public Library Foundation boards. Over the decades, John somehow found time to, because his legal practice was extraordinarily busy, to continue to serve all these organizations and others, including the Evergreen Memorial Historic Cemetery and Friends of the California Citrus Park. He's provided endless time and leadership in support of their efforts to preserve and enhance Riverside's cultural history and community services. But perhaps the thing that I think would maybe John's greatest mark on the community was that in the early 2000s, he became chair of the City of Riverside's Homeless Advisory Commission. During that time, the commission developed an early continuum of care model that the Riverside City Council adopted and implemented. And if you remember that time in the early 2000s, it was a very difficult time with homelessness in downtown Riverside, in White Park, and on the mall. And John was instrumental in finding a creative solution to solve that problem. To this day, the city is served by the programs established by that model, which are full-time street outreach teams, homeless shelters, a social service village called Hewland Place, and a Housing First initiative that's now being used throughout the state to address homelessness. And John, since you're no longer practicing law full-time, there are certainly other areas in the state that could perhaps use your help on that front. In addition to his local community service, John served as a two-term treasurer and vice president of the California Historical Society Board of Trustees, and he recently returned to its board. He's also currently president of the board of directors of the Sam and Alfreda Maloof Foundation for Arts and Crafts, and also serves as an important member of the City of Riverside's Cultural Heritage Board. Over the course of his career, John has truly been a role model, both for his colleagues, including the many attorneys he's mentored, and for the communities that he's been a part of, not just the Riverside community, but all the communities for which he has served as city attorney or through other public agencies. And for that reason, it's entirely appropriate to add his name to the list of BBK colleagues who previously received this award, which include Eugene Best, Art Littleworth, John Babbage, John Gabbert, Jack Clark Jr., and Virginia Phillips. I'm personally very grateful to John because BBK's culture today is very much influenced by John passing on and the mentoring he's done from what he learned from Jim Krieger and other BBK partners, including some of the prior recipients of this award. And reading about Jim Krieger, it struck me how much of our firm's culture today is impacted, you know, by Jim and by John carrying that on. And finally, on a personal level, I have to say it's been a pleasure knowing John for more than three decades. And John has a unique personality. He's extremely smart and creative, sometimes outspoken, and sometimes when he thinks it's necessary to move things forward, a provocateur. I first got to know him when I worked for him as a very junior associate, which was often a wild and adventurous learning experience, I'll say. I guess there was being Kriegerized. I'm not sure what the John Brown equivalent was, but I can assure you there was one. I was partner with him for 25 years, and the last 15 when I've been managing partner, he was a great ally and just a great asset to the firm. I always enjoy a conversation with him, whether it's about his passions, like travel or art or wine or reminiscing about BBK history, which we were doing just before this event began. And that, I have to say, includes an unforgettable firm Halloween party he threw where he dressed as Gomez Adams from the Adams family, which sometimes seems like a role he was born to play. So it is a great pleasure. And without further ado, let me introduce you to the very deserving recipient of the 2020 James H. Krieger Award for Meritorious Service, John Brown.
Thank you, Eric. I'm, of course, honored to receive the Riverside County Bar Association's James H. Krieger Meritorious Service Award. As Eric mentioned, I wanted to acknowledge that my 45-year legal career as a public lawyer at Best Best & Krieger was a result of a less than 30-minute visit with Jim Krieger in late 1974. As a result of a very chance meeting with Charlie Field and Chris Carpenter at my law school in Berkeley that fall, I interviewed with the firm in Riverside, and particularly remember a young lawyer and an exuberant lawyer by the name of Dallas Holmes telling me he had arranged for me to interview with Jim Krieger very briefly. I felt I was on the cusp of having a visit with the Pope. That short meeting with Jim sealed the deal as far as I was concerned. He had a remarkable vision for BB&K, which has driven me for all of my public law career, for the firm to be a public law firm practicing throughout California and even nationally, with a focus on water and special district law and emerging areas of public law, such as natural resources, CEQA, toxics, hazardous water, and even municipal law. Most importantly, I think at the end of that conversation was the fact that Jim Krieger had embraced the idea of not having necessarily to sell your soul to the devil by joining a private law firm. I was on the cusp of joining the Los Angeles City Attorney's Office at that point, but by enveloping himself and enabling me to envision myself in the firm's 85-year culture at that point of both professional and community service, I joined the firm the following year. When I arrived at the firm in late 1975, I remember being told a little bit about Eugene Best's 65-year history of community service. As we approached my new office just outside of the law library at BB&K's building at 4200 Orange Street, I noticed that the name tag posted on the hallway outside my new office said Eugene Best. I was a bit taken aback, but I was immediately presented with my own name tag. I was told that Gene, who was well into his 80s, only came in on Friday mornings for our very famous donut day. And that is how Mr. Best and I came to share an office for the last few years of his life. It was an honor and a pleasure. And dutifully every Friday morning, I took my name tag off and put his in. Many of you know that Gene was president of the Riverside County Bar Association in 1933, one of 12 BB&K lawyers I have worked with or known who served as presidents of this Riverside County Bar Association. I wanted to acknowledge briefly two critical influences of my own career, long passion for community service, my family and my law firm. When my dad returned from the war in 1947 to our small farming town of 800 in Michigan, community involvement was a cornerstone of our family life for the next 15 years. And I was reminded of that recently during some of the demonstrations in downtown Riverside for social justice that left some of the streets littered and tagged. And I walked down one day and watched a number of families with very young children cleaning up. As a small boy, I similarly tagged along with my mom and dad to endless community service projects, including successful efforts to raise the money to build a mid-century modern public library for a town of 800 and to replace the town's old Carnegie Library, and a separate effort to build an aquatic center and Olympic state sized pool. I was a habituate of both the library and the pool for the first 10 years of my life, and perhaps that wedded me to this idea of giving back. Finally, my law firm, true to the passions of the Bess and the Krieger, as have been mentioned, their successors as firm leaders, including Eric Garner, have made community service a bedrock of becoming a successful lawyer at the firm. A week after passing the bar in 1975, I was placed on the front lines of the firm's then pro bono free legal clinic at 4200 Orange Street, which took place every Friday morning from 8 to noon. And shortly thereafter, I was thrilled to land my first client, the punk rock Latin band War. And although my legal representation lasted only 3 days until the recording studio got wind of my burgeoning entertainment law career, those were heady times. Later, as Eric has mentioned, partners Art Littleworth, Dallas Holmes, Dick Anderson, among others, pulled me into years of work to form the Mission Inn Foundation and save the Mission Inn. And I later worked with Dallas on groundbreaking efforts to preserve Riverside's greenbelt through growth control initiatives. During all of the subsequent decades, the firm encouraged my involvement on numerous community boards and commissions, and that made all the difference, including a difficult 3 years, as Eric mentioned, as chair of Riverside's first homeless advisory commission. I won't pretend, as all of us know, that we've eliminated those issues in the city of Riverside, but I think we do have a framework consistent with many of the leading cities in the United States that have tried to address issues of homelessness. To me and the firm and my many colleagues who have undertaken similar community service efforts, it was all about giving back to the communities in which we earn our living. I can tell you that it was sometimes not difficult to go up to community cleanup days in towns like Apple Valley, but I always came back energized with that sense of melding both my public law practice with a better understanding of the community that employed us as its town attorney. For that, I'm grateful, extremely grateful for the firm's support, and very much want to thank all of you.
Thank you, John. Congratulations on the James H. Krieger Award, well-deserved. I once knew an attorney named John Brown from the South. He was a gentleman, he was a scholar. He reminded me of Atticus Finch. Your career and accomplishments fit the same. It's amazing, congratulations again. At this point in time, we are now going to have the installation of the barrister officers. I'd like to call upon Commissioner Belinda Handy to introduce our barristers and administer the oath.
Okay, sorry. Good afternoon. I'm Commissioner Belinda Handy, and I'm here with most of the barristers. Okay, so first, let me go ahead and introduce our barristers. Our past president, Paul Lynn. Member at large, Alejandro Barraza. Member at large, Antique Fakta. Also member at large, Kevin Collins. Member at large, Braden Holly. Member at large, Brigitte Wilcox. Secretary, Lauren Vogt. Treasurer, David Rivera. President-elect, Michael Ortiz. And our president, Goshi Farouk. At this time, would you please raise your hand and I will administer the oath. Do you and each of you solemnly swear to fully and faithfully carry out and execute your duties and responsibilities as officers of the barristers, and to bear allegiance to the barrister precepts that all attorneys stand equal before the bar? If so, answer stating, I do. Thank you all, and it's a pleasure being here today.
Before we leave the barristers, I understand that we have to take a photograph. So would you all get next to the cameras? You can start drinking again once you're done. Apparently you barristers are doing it right. So get next to the cameras, all of you who are either on your own or they're at the, I'm not sure where you are, but it looks like it's fun. And we're going to take a picture of you, all right? So smile for the camera.
Take a picture of us?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, everybody. I'll take it on. One, two, one.
That's so.
All right, that was great. One more.
All right, that was great. Three. One more. Uno más.
Three, two, one. There we go. All right, thanks, everybody.
Thank you. Barristers, by the way, where are you all celebrating at?
We're at Prohibition.
Of course.
Come on down.
Oh, great.
Right there, I can see you.
Maybe nice after. Thank you. So now at this point in time of the program, we'd like to do the installation of the Riverside County Bar Association Board of Directors. I'd like to call upon the Honorable Judge Jack Lucky to introduce our RCBA board members and administer the oath.
All right, and good afternoon, everybody. I'm gonna introduce our incoming board members and I'm gonna ask them to turn on their video. Oh, they're a step ahead of me and they're already turning on their video. But we need Goshi Farouk, who is Barrister's President, Jack Clark, the immediate past president, Aaron Chandler, Director at Large, Elizabeth Lord, Director at Large, Megan Demschke, Director at Large, Chris Johnson, there he is, Director at Large, Mark Easter, our incoming secretary, Kelly Moran, chief financial officer, Lori Myers, our incoming vice president, Neil Okazaki, our president-elect, and Sophia Choi, our incoming president. And I got a note asking you not to unmute yourselves because I guess there's only so much audio we can take at a time. But before we get to the oath and I have you looking awkwardly into your cameras, I want to talk a little bit about this rich legacy that we've heard about the Riverside County Bar Association, this legacy of legal service combined, legal excellence combined with service. And I think that this board, I know all of you, you typify what the legacy of RCBA is. And the things that we've heard about our award recipients this year, energy and positivity, generosity and humility, mentorship and this sense of family. I think that our experiences together throughout the years have shown us that this board typifies those qualities and is well situated to carry on that legacy. And I think about that sense of mentorship and family. One of the things that I noticed in the chat was Justice Codrington saying to our incoming president, Sophia Choi, we're like family. And I do feel that sense of family in the Riverside legal community at large, and also in particular, the Riverside County Bar Association. And when we look at the work that you do as a board and the programs that RCBA has done, New Attorneys Academy, the Elves, the work that you do with Affinity Bars and getting the small bar associations and giving them the resources necessary to provide MCLE, giving them places to meet, giving them resources so that the granddaddy of them all in terms of Affinity Bars in the Inland Empire, RT Fields Bar Association, Apolly, and our newbie, HBAIE, have the resources, the personnel, and the mentorship, the family, to be successful in this legal environment. I think that we see RCBA's good work all the time. We see the people who are responsible for it on our screens right now. And it is my privilege and pleasure to swear you in as our incoming board. And I don't see Sophia on video, but it may be because I'm looking at this on an iPad. There she is. All right. So I am going to ask everybody to raise their right hands to take the oath at this time and repeat after me. I do solemnly swear.
I do solemnly swear.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
That I will uphold the bylaws of the association.
That I will uphold the bylaws of the association.
That I take this obligation freely.
That I take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion.
Without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion.
And that I will well and faithfully discharge the duties.
And that I will well and faithfully discharge the duties.
Upon which I am about to enter.
Upon which I am about to enter.
And members of RCBA, I present to you our new board, and I can hear the thunderous applause even inside my house. Congratulations.
Thank you, Judge Lucky.
Thank you. And new board members, please keep your screens on, your videos on, because they are going to take a picture of you. So please smile, and we'll take the picture.
Okay, I'll give the countdown on 1, 3, 2, 1. All right, one more. 3, 2, 1. All right, thanks everybody.
Fantastic, amazing. Congratulations to the new RCBA board. At this time, it's going to be my distinct honor and pleasure to introduce your new incoming president, or the newly sworn-in president, Sophia Choi. I'd like to spend this time, first of all, giving thanks to all of you for inviting me to MC this event. I'm learning so much, particularly about Zoom, which I've never used before, and I just figured out how to get the chat session up. And I'm starting to see all of the wonderful comments that you're all receiving. Well deserved. I want to talk to you a little bit about Sophia. So in February of 2020, we stole Sophia from the Riverside County Council because we recognize what an amazing attorney, what a professional she is, how energetic and simply just bright. That's the words that come to mind as I start speaking about her. And so when Sophia came to our office, she was assigned to our Special Operations Appellate Prosecutions. The acronym for them is SOAP. And the acronym is fitting because one of their jobs is to clean up the messes that we get ourselves into here in our office. One of Sophia's first assignments was to keep me from being taken into custody. It was a federal case that we were involved in Los Angeles, and Judge Dolly G issued an OSC, Ray Contempt, for me because our office was protecting and continued to protect the identity of a confidential informant. It's so hard to trust the feds nowadays, but in any event, Sophia was successful in keeping me out of jail. I guess I could have emceed this event from virtually from the Federal Detention Center, but I'm thankful that that did not happen. And I'm so thankful for Sophia and her talents and skills. As part of this and getting prepared to be the MC today, I wanted to speak to Sophia and I asked her a question. I said, so what, if you had one opportunity in this world to do, what would you change? Or what would you try to do? Especially in your job now as the president of RCBA. And she joked and said, well, that sounds like a Miss America question. Of course I want world peace. And it sort of gave me a glimpse into Sophia that she actually had a really funny sense of humor. She then indicated to me that she really liked to live her life by the saying by Mahatma Gandhi, which was, be the change you wish to see in the world. She indicated to me that it was so hard to control other people, but you certainly could strive to control yourself. She wanted to see less judging of other people and less complaining and more positivity and happiness in the world. To see that change, she indicated that she needed to start with herself and her family. She always reminds herself that she is blessed to have a family that supports and loves her. and that she's fortunate to have had the career that she had with the County Council's office and now starting out here with the Riverside County District Attorney's Office. Sophia is a woman of faith. She is grateful for all that God has given her in her life. And so in order to see the change in the world that she needed to see in herself, she wanted to tell you all that she is so grateful and blessed to be here today practicing law in Riverside, to be a member of the Riverside County Bar Association, to have the support and love of her family, and to truly say that she wants to be the help and the change with kindness and love for the Riverside County Bar Association and as its president. I wanted to give you just a glimpse before she makes her comments of the person that she is on a professional level. She started at at Notre Dame High School. And again, I took some notes down and I typically try to commit these to memory, but her list of accomplishments and professional achievements were so long I had to write them down and type them out. And so she started out at Notre Dame High School as the valedictorian. She then went to the University of California, where she received her Bachelor of Arts and graduated magna cum laude. She then went to Southwestern University School of Law, where most of us go to a three-year institution and some of us four at for night school. Sylvia went through the SCALE program and accomplished obtaining her Juris Doctorate in 2 years. She then started her career with the Riverside County County Council in their code enforcement and land use litigation section. She was there from 2006 to 2020, where she came on board with the Riverside County District Attorney's Office in February. Some of the list of her accomplishments, and they were long, so I tried to shorten them down to some of the most amazing things that she's done. She has been the past president of the Leo Deegan American Inns of Court. She has been a board member and vice president international of the Korean Prosecutors Association. She is now, she's filled almost every, in fact, every position in the Riverside County Bar Association, including a director at large on the membership committee, secretary, finance committee chair, chief financial officer, vice president, nominating committee. She was the president-elect and then president currently. She spearheaded the fundraising effort, as you heard earlier, that raised approximately $25,000, which is an amazing accomplishment. She's also been a director at large for the Riverside County Barristers Association, and she was the co-founder and inaugural president of the Asian Pacific American Lawyers Inland Empire, or APALI. Sylvia, I'd like to end and introduce or invite you to come up and provide your comments. But before I do, I'd like to say congratulations. The Riverside County Bar Association is in good hands with you at the helm. And we all look forward to some amazing and positive events that'll happen in this year. We can all agree that we'd all like to forget 2020 at some point in time, but I know that with your efforts and your skill set, and especially your devotion and dedication to service, that we will see some amazing things coming out of the Riverside County Bar Association. And with that, I'd like to invite Sophia Choi to come up and provide her president's comments.
Thank you, John, so much for that wonderful introduction. I do think at one point you called me Sylvia Choi, my sister. It happens to me all the time, so I'm used to it. I know I did a training before where I said, one day everyone will call me Sylvia, or call my sister Sophia sister instead of calling me Sylvia sister. So thank you everyone so much for participating in our first ever virtual installation. I was looking at the number of attendees and we were at almost 200 participants, and that's not including the Facebook live stream that was happening. So for an event by Zoom, that is amazing. And I thank you so much for your support. Although it would have been nice to see everyone and share handshakes and hugs in person, this virtual installation actually brought together people who may not have been able to attend otherwise, from out of the county, out of the state, and even out of the country in Korea with some of my relatives watching. So thank you for zooming in. If the hardest part of writing your remarks is how not to talk for 5 hours straight because you have so many people to thank, then you know you have been blessed with good people in your life. And I want to emphasize and start out by saying that the specific people I named today is nowhere near the number of people I am thankful for and to. I really want to thank the members of the RCBA for entrusting me with this role as president. It's definitely not a position that I take lightly, and I will work diligently and do my best so that after a year from now, there have been noticeable changes, good changes, to the RCBA and more benefits for its members. To that end, I look forward to working with the RCBA and Barristers boards that was just installed. I really wanted to thank the sponsors this year. Chief Assistant District Attorney John Aki read out a very extensive list of sponsors. All of our sponsors were so willing to help, and I am so grateful for the generosity they have shown. We have raised over $25,000 this year, which is the most ever for any installation. So with the sponsorships raised, we had promised the members that we would get new training tables and chairs for the Gabbert Gallery of the RCBA building. We have raised far beyond the amount needed to do so. We have already ordered the tables and chairs and they have arrived. They look beautiful. And so hopefully your Gabbert Gallery experience will be even better, especially with the renovation of the RCBA building completed during Jack Clark's term as president. My goals this year is to increase membership benefits, increase membership, to preserve the rich history of the Riverside County Bar Association, which was established back in 1894, to give back to the community, and to increase more social media and online presence. We have already started an Instagram page. Please follow us, it's RivCoBar. I think we have 119 followers right now. I'm trying to get that up by the time I'm done with this year. Hopefully over 1,000 at a minimum. I am confident that this board can work together to achieve these goals. I won't bore you with the details, but please be sure to read each month's president's column of the Riverside Lawyer magazine, as I plan to keep every member apprised of new developments of the Bar Association through the president's column and through social media. I also wanted to take this opportunity to thank all the RCBA employees and the board members, and especially our executive director, Charlene Nelson, who really is loved by all, especially me. I know that to achieve the goals of the RCBA, it means that it requires the cooperation and dedication of everyone involved. Some of the work gets recognized and some of the work doesn't. Don't. There are so many people, committees, and sections involved in the RCBA. Their dedication and hard work are what make RCBA an organization that can give back, and I look forward to working with everyone. There are so many people who have helped me grow and learn as a lawyer for 14 wonderful years. Due to limited time, I cannot name all of them today, but I wanted to name some that are here virtually to celebrate today that have really guided me throughout the years and who continue to guide me now, including our MC, Chief Assistant District Attorney Jonna Key, installing officer Judge Jackson Lucky, and his wife Deborah Lucky, who is a managing DDA at the office, and both of whom are like family to my family. My wonderful and supportive supervisor, who always supports me no matter what and always encourages me, managing DDA Alan Tate, assistant DA Elena Bentley, who is so supportive and was so kind to share the Zoom link for today's installation with the entire office. Chief DDA Kelly Catlett, whose birthday is today and is still watching, thank you very much and happy birthday. Chief DDA Sam Kalushin, Assistant DA Jerry Feynman, Chief DDA Brandon Smith and his beautiful wife, Ashley Smith, who is a senior DDA, Chief DDA Vince Fabricio and his wife, Kim, who I worked very closely with when I did juvenile dependency cases and who is also my good friend, and DA Mike Hestrin, who was unable to attend today due to a prior engagement, but who has supported me for so many years, and I thank him very much. And thank you to everyone in the DA's office who has really been so wonderful to me and so supportive, who may also be watching. Also watching, Riverside Public Defender Steve Harmon, who has been there for me for most of my career since we've been on the same Leo A. Deegan INSA court team about a decade ago. Robin Lewis, who you've heard present earlier, who I believe was actually the first person who got me involved into the Bar Association. So thank you for doing that, Robin. Greg Rizzio, who was our first sponsor this year and diamond sponsor, who really encouraged me and gave me hope that although this installation is going to be virtual, that it will be successful and well attended. And he was right. Justice Richard T. Fields, Justice Carol D. Codrington, who is like family to me, and my family really loves her, and I believe she loves her family. Justice Douglas Miller, all three justices have supported me since we started APALI about 10 years ago, and the 4th District Court of Appeal Division II justices have always been so supportive, including Justice Manuel Ramirez, who was unable to watch today, but he has been so supportive of me for pretty much my whole legal career. So thank you to everyone from the 4th DCA Court of Appeal. Judge Eric Keene, whom I have worked very closely with on the INSA court board. My good friend, Judge Jennifer Gerard, who always listens to me vent and is a very close friend. Judge Sunshine Sykes, who is also a very good friend of mine. Also thank you to LA County Judge Susan Jung Townsend, who is just so thoughtful and thinks of things that I can never think of. She sent me really beautiful flowers yesterday to my home to congratulate me. Judge Ann Park, also from LA County, and Jerry Yang, a longtime friend who was recently promoted as the chief of the Riverside branch of the U.S. Attorney's Office. Thank you for always being supportive. And there are so many more people to name, all my close friends who are watching that I'm always talking to and confiding in. I'm thinking of the names in my head, but I don't want to name some and exclude others. So I hope you know who you are. I've been texting with a lot of you during the installation as well. And to everyone watching today, thank you for supporting and joining. And all of my friends, mentors, judges, here today, and those that are not here today who have supported me, thank you so much. Friends from the various organizations I have been heavily involved in as a board member, including the Korean Prosecutors Association, APALI, Rio A. Deegan INSA Court, my friends and former colleagues from the County Counsel's Office and from Code Enforcement, and my church friends who are here supporting as well. So thank you so much. Also watching is Principal Rayana Ashton of my high school, Notre Dame, here in Riverside, as well as Chris Johnson. I recall, I just had responded to his chat message congratulating too. And I believe some of the students from Notre Dame are watching as well. So thank you and hello. Friends and leaders from my employer, the Riverside County DA's office, thank you so much for supporting me like I'm family. Also, the list of sponsors and list of dignitaries that Chief Assistant DA Jonna Key has read out in the beginning. Most of them are people who have been supportive throughout my career, and I won't list everyone now, but I want to emphasize that these are the people who have seen me throughout the year and have been extremely supportive. I am so grateful to everyone who has supported me throughout the years, and thank God that I have been blessed with you in my life. I could see why when I watch TV and people get an award, they get flustered trying to name everyone that they can think of to thank. I feel the same way. There are so many more people I want to thank today, but due to limited time, I can't. So I hope that there will be many opportunities for me to do so in the near future. Also, most importantly, I want to take this opportunity to thank my family. They have prayed for me every chance they get, wishing for my health, happiness, and success, as if that's their purpose in life. So because I don't say thank you in my daily life like I should, I want to say today, I love you and thank you so much for loving me, supporting me, and being my family. And hello and thank you to my extended family watching from different counties, states, and Korea. Because it's Zoom, that was possible. Thank you so much to wonderful Riverside County District Attorney's Office and Senior DDA Ashley Smith for letting me use this wonderful training room here in our building and setting up all the technology so that it can go well. You have shown me so much support, and I am so grateful. Amy McKenzie, John Hall, and Devin Michaels, who's actually sitting in this room right now, have been so helpful in promoting the installation on social media, and I'm so grateful for your support. Also, special thanks for working together on the logistics to be able to do this installation virtually. Megan Demschke and Danny Zapeda of Aiken Cone, Charlene Nelson and Lisa Yang from the Bar Association. It really took a lot of time and work to put it together because we've never done an installation by Zoom before. And the four of them were so great to work with, and we were able to have this installation thanks to them. So I thank you so much. Everyone here watching today, I am grateful to. And there are so many more names to name, but I hope that you will be understanding that because of the time constraints, I can't name everyone, but I hope we will see each other and catch up soon. And please stay tuned for the video. There's a video at the end from many dignitaries with congratulatory remarks, who are also everyone I would like to thank, so please stay on to watch. Finally, I would like to give tribute to Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, who, as everyone knows, has recently passed away. Regardless of any party affiliation, she is a role model for so many people, including for myself. When asked how she would like to be remembered, she said, "Someone who used whatever talent she had to do her work to the very best of her ability." I am confident that this is how she will be remembered. And with the same message as my guide, I will work hard for RCBA, its members, and the community with the best of my abilities. We also lost a respected and loved judge in our own Riverside legal community, Judge Hanks. I hope that all of us will remember the impact he has left in our community. Thank you everyone for coming and celebrating, coming virtually. I love the Riverside legal community that I am a part of. Congratulations, RCBA board. Congratulations, Barristers President Gusha Farouk and board. and I look forward to a great year. Thank you so much for your support, and thank you for watching.
Thank you, Sophia. Thank you for the kind words and remarks. As Sophia indicated, there will be a short video being played of congratulatory remarks. I hope that all of the barristers, the newly installed barristers, and members of the RCBA board have a chance to take a look at the comments. I was able to finally pull the chat up in its entirety, and it's amazing the comments that are being received today. So thank you everyone for attending this year's installation. We hope you have safe and that you are safe, that you continue to remain safe and healthy, and hope for a better year following this day. So here's the video. Congratulations again. Have a great day. We're adjourned.
Hi. Hi, my name is Sophia Choi. Thank you so much for attending today's inaugural virtual installation of the Riverside County Bar Association and its board. Please enjoy our videos from our dignitaries. Thank you for coming.
My name is Mike Hester, and I'm the Riverside County District Attorney. I'm very pleased and honored to have this opportunity to congratulate the incoming RCBA President, Ms. Sophia Choi, and also to congratulate the entire incoming RCBA board. I want to take just a few minutes to discuss Ms. Choi with you. Ms. Choi has lived in Riverside since the age of 7. She attended Notre Dame High School, graduating as the valedictorian. She then followed that with UCLA, where she did her undergraduate work. She graduated UCLA in 2 years with the highest honors. Followed that by going to Southwestern Law School, where she also finished her legal studies in 2 years through a special program. Ms. Choi then spent the last 14 years since 2006 as a deputy county counsel, where by all accounts, she served with distinction. I'm pleased to tell you that recently, Ms. Choi started at the district attorney's office and is now one of my deputy district attorneys. We're incredibly fortunate to have her and very impressed and looking forward to the great work she's going to do for the people of Riverside County. Congratulations, Sophia Choi. Congratulations, RCBA. It's going to be a great year.
This is Steve Harmon. Congratulations to everyone on the new board. You know, this is going to be a very challenging year for all of you in many different ways. It will take a great amount of ingenuity and hard work for you to guide us, our Bar Association, through this difficult year ahead. But I know you can do it. Sophia will be a great leader, and I know each of you will do your part. And when this year is over, you will all be very tired, but you will also be very proud of what you have accomplished. And all of us in the Bar Association will be very thankful for what you've done for us. So good luck.
Good afternoon. I'm Richard Roth, and I'm privileged to serve as your California State Senator. First, I want to thank the Riverside County Bar Association for over 125 years of incredible service to our community, our region, and our state. From legal aid to the indigent and support for foster children, to mock trial and civic engagement in our schools, your Bar Association has truly made a difference. But organizations do not run themselves. They depend on highly dedicated, talented, and focused leaders to do so. And that's exactly what we've had over the years at the Riverside County Bar Association. Leaders just like Sophia Choi and Gusha Farouk. Sophia, as the incoming president of the bar, you join an extraordinary roster of distinguished attorney leaders who have steered this organization over the course of its history. A group of 100 past presidents dating back to 1894, including 9 of my former colleagues, 3 of whom, Enos Reed, John Babbage, and Ho Coyle, hired me and gave me a chance to practice law in Riverside almost 40 years ago. Sophia, congratulations on your presidency. Gusha, congratulations on your barrister's presidency, and I look forward to watching both of you and your talented boards continue to soar. Keep up the great work. Finally, I want to also congratulate John Brown and Greg Rizzio, recipients of the Krieger and Hughes Meritorious Service Awards. Your professional and civic accomplishments are legendary, and you make us all very, very proud.
Good afternoon, my fellow members of the RCBA. My name is David Bristow, and it's a pleasure to be with you this afternoon as part of the 101st Annual Installation of Officers and Directors for the Riverside County Bar Association. Today, we will honor our incoming slate of officers and directors, including President Sophia Choi, as well as our outgoing president, Jack Clark Jr. And we'll also honor our two award recipients, John Brown of Best and Krieger, and Greg Rizzio of Rizzio and Lipinski. Finally, we will acknowledge those of our members who have been that for 50 years, 50-year membership in the RCBA, a group that includes the Honorable Stephen Cunnison. Perhaps like many of you, I was not happy that we couldn't have our installation as we customarily do this year. Ordinarily, of course, we would be meeting in the ballroom of the Mission Inn Hotel, where we would enjoy a nice dinner, much conviviality, and most importantly, we'd catch up with those friends and colleagues of ours that we see once a year at installation. For me, that's people like Sandy Lear, Mike Klepper, a host of friends and lawyers that I don't see often enough, which is why I look forward every year to installation, as I have done for the 27 years I've been a member of this organization. But as I say, that is what we ordinarily do, and of course, 2020 is anything but an ordinary year. The COVID-19 pandemic has wreaked havoc on our nation, on our world, and imposed or inflicted hardship on so many people that really having a virtual installation ceremony is a relatively minor inconvenience. I'm certain that next year, 2021, will make up for our lack of dinner and conviviality this year and redouble our efforts. But I have reflected on what the pandemic can mean and has meant for our Bar Association. You know, I guess it's made me think that leadership matters. And we've seen that in our response to this COVID crisis across our nation, across our state. And good leaders have stepped forward and bad leaders have been exposed. And in times of crisis, I think those leadership skills become all the more important. We want people who can instill confidence and inspire us and propose solutions to very difficult problems and lead us out of a difficult circumstance into a better place. And I believe that the RCBA is fortunate to have Sophia Choi as our incoming president, because she, like her predecessor, possesses those skill sets. Sophia was quick to adapt to the fact that our installation dinner was at first going to be postponed and then canceled. And her ability to pivot and make the best out of a bad situation has demonstrated her capabilities to serve in the capacity as president of the RCBA. I believe she and the rest of the board will have a steady hand on the tiller as we move through 2020 and into 2021. I hope all of you, my fellow members, are safe and your families are safe, and that you are navigating these difficult times with as much success and aplomb as is possible under the circumstances. But as I again reflect on our skills as lawyers, on our place in the community, where we possess skills and knowledge and abilities that many of our fellow citizens don't. Perhaps this pandemic is an opportunity for us to once more help our communities in ways that we are unusually gifted at. So I would encourage all of you to consider helping out where you can, with our courts as mediators to help reduce the backlog, with our legal clinics to help provide guidance to those who can't afford to hire a lawyer, and with any other resources that we may be able to provide to our communities. It's a pleasure and an honor to be a member of the RCBA, a very special place for a professional to learn how to be a lawyer and to continue to practice to be a lawyer. So to Sophia and Jack and the rest of our Bar Association officers and directors, thank you for your service. I sincerely commend you on your future. And to all the rest of you out there, I look forward to seeing you in person next year. Thanks very much.
Hello to all. Welcome to our annual Riverside County Bar Association installation ceremony for the year 2021. And I know, and you know as well, that we are all working within the limitations of the coronavirus. And as the presiding justice of our Court of Appeal, not only am I honored to appear before you, but I am broadcasting for your information and sending this message to each of you via this court's Blue Jeans software program. And it is through this format that I send my congratulations to our newest president, Ms. Sophia Choi. And Sophia, as you begin your term as our new president of the Bar Association, our very best and heartiest wishes and congratulations as you step into the position for the year 2020 and 2021. You have my continued best wishes for every success as you confront the challenges that will test and challenge you personally and professionally, unlike anything you've ever confronted in life. Knowing you as I do, however, over these many years, I know that you will be more than up to the challenges that will come your way. Please also allow me to congratulate all of the new and incoming board members, as all of you join with you, Sophia, to chart a new course and a new direction for our Bar Association. And of course, a word or two to congratulate Jack Clark and his immediate past board members for their dedication and hard work as the leaders of our Bar Association throughout the year 2019-2020. Collectively, Jack, yours was a year committed to bringing awareness and progress to all of the issues confronted by each of you in this past year. And finally, Sophia Choi, Madam President of our Bar Association for the year 2020-2021. While I am very happy and excited for you personally and for you professionally as you assume the leadership role of our Bar Association, I am somewhat saddened, bittersweet, you might say, that we are conducting these ceremonial proceedings in a virtual world, and I am disappointed that your parents and your beautiful family aren't going to see you installed in the stunning music room of the Mission Inn. So congratulations to them for instilling in you the values, the character, and the leadership qualities that you exude and will bring to our Bar Association. And I can't begin to imagine the pride that your parents are feeling and enjoying as they, as their hardworking and accomplished daughter becomes the leader of this grand and special organization, the Riverside County Bar Association, for which you have been elected as our newest president. Sophia, congratulations to you, best wishes, and good luck to you throughout the year of your presidency. Thank you all, and enjoy the virtual world ceremonies.
Good afternoon, and thank you for inviting me to be among those who are extending our congratulations to all of the Riverside County Bar officers who are being installed this afternoon, especially to your presidents, Sophia Choi and Gusha Farouk. I was really pleased to hear that your presidents will be making as a focus of their tenure, history and technology. As many of you know, Riverside County has a very rich history, beginning with our original inhabitants of this county, the Luiseno, Cupeno, and Cahuilla Native American communities. In the mid-1800s, the United States took control of this region from Mexico, and in 1893, Riverside County was first established. It was named after its city center's location on the side of the Santa Ana River. Later that next year, in 1894, the Riverside County Bar Association was founded. Since that time, Riverside County has really grown. I know that since I first came to this region in the 1990s, our population has more than doubled, and we have seen more than our fair share of challenges to overcome. Supreme Court Justice Lewis Powell once said, "History balances the frustration of how far we have to go with the satisfaction of knowing how far we have come. It teaches us tolerance for human shortcomings and imperfections, which are not only unique to our generation, but of all time." Currently, we have four crises that are not only affecting our nation, but also our local communities, involving an economic crisis, racial inequalities, political strife, and of course, the pandemic. But I'm confident that when we rely on history, we are far less likely to make the same mistakes we made in the past, and that when we rely on technology, we find new and better ways to move forward, and that when we keep our collaborative process, like Riverside County Bar Association has always shared with our courts, we are far more likely to lead our county, our legal community, and our courts in the best way. Again, on behalf of the Civil Division of the Riverside County Superior Court, I want to extend our heartfelt congratulations to all of the officers, and especially to your presidents, Sophia Choi and Gushia Farouk. We look forward to working with you in the coming year. Thank you.
Hello, everyone, and good afternoon. I'm guessing most of you are like me and are ready for this year to be over so we can get back to our regular in-person meetings, court hearings, and installation ceremonies. I'm sorry that today's event has to be virtual, but in a glass half-empty fashion, you are the first board to ever have a virtual installation of officers, so that's cool. I want to commend the new officers for taking on this added responsibility of representing our legal community while increasing the footprint and influence of the Riverside County Bar Association. I would like to offer a special congratulations to past president Jack Clark for a job well done. Sophia, you have big shoes to fill, but I am confident you're going to do an amazing job. Congratulations.
Ms. Choi, congratulations on becoming president of the Riverside County Bar Association. It's both an honor and a responsibility. And to all of the Bar Association officers and barristers officers, congratulations and thank you. This is a very difficult time to be a leader in any organization. Your peers selected you because they think you have what it takes to be leaders. I'm sure they're right. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Robin Lewis. I had the honor and privilege to serve as the Bar Association President for the Riverside County Bar Association in 2011 to 2012. I'm currently the chair of the Past Presidents Committee for the Bar Association, and I'm also the chair of the New Attorney Academy, which is a training program for new attorneys that is run by the Riverside County Bar Association, the Riverside Superior Court, and the American Board of Trial Advocates, also known as ABOTA. I first would like to congratulate Sophia Choi on her installation as this year's Bar Association President. Sophia, I am so proud of all that you have accomplished. I know that the Bar Association could not be in better hands. This is a challenging time. 2020 has really turned out to be quite a year. And I know that, Sophia, you are up to the task. You are going to have a very difficult year as we navigate through these uncharted waters, but I know that you are the person to lead us through that. I'd also like to congratulate all of the incoming board members. What a great experience you're going to have. Having served on the Riverside County Bar Association Board was one of the best experiences and the most rewarding experiences that I have. And I'm so proud to be part of such a wonderful organization. I say this all the time, and I know that so many people say this all the time, but we are so fortunate to be able to say that we practice in Riverside. Riverside is such a tight, close-knit community, and I can't imagine practicing law anywhere else. To Sophia and to the board, I know that this is going to be a very difficult year with curveballs being thrown at you that none of us can even imagine. But know that you have an entire legal community standing behind you, and know that if there's anything that any one of us can do, we will be there for you. I'd also like to take this moment to thank Charlene Nelson for all of her efforts. Charlene Nelson is the executive director of the Riverside County Bar Association, and she runs the show. So she is there dedicated every day, working to make sure that our Bar Association is successful as it can be. And I personally want to thank her, not only for her friendship, but all of the efforts that she puts in to help make Riverside the community that it is. Thank you all very much.
Hello, I'm Chris Jensen, President and Chairman of the Board of RCBA Dispute Resolution Services, known as DRS, a sibling organization to our Riverside County Bar Association. Allow me on behalf of the more than 70 mediators and arbitrators of DRS to congratulate Jack Clark and the outgoing RCBA board on their successful year of stewardship of the Riverside County Bar Association. Jack and the board have experienced multiple national and worldwide issues which have impacted our organization. They are to be commended for successfully keeping our bar association on track and moving forward. Next, please allow me to congratulate Sophia Choi, our new president, Neil Okasaki, president-elect, and the new officers and directors of the Riverside County Bar Association. Sophia and the officers and directors are taking over the helm at this difficult time in our society. Not since the 1960s have we experienced such civil unrest, and except for reading about a pandemic in the history books, none of us have experienced our world's current medical crisis. And it's this crisis which will strain our bar's ability to undertake the variety of tasks for which we provide such a great service to our community. We are involved in, support, and operate a variety of beneficial community services, from lawyer referral to holiday assistance, dispensing legal advice, teaching our youth, filling a void in dispute resolution, to name just a few of the community services for which RCBA is well known. And these benefits take time and money. And this is at a time when we're all struggling to keep our businesses afloat, represent those in need, and otherwise defend and support the Constitution as we have sworn to do. Yet throughout our Bar Association's over 100-year history, through wars, a depression, and a variety of other societal obstacles, our Bar Association has stayed the course. And now the weight of such falls on the shoulders of Sophia and the new officers and directors of the Riverside County Bar Association. Please accept our gratitude for taking on this task. Thank you in advance for staying the course. One final congratulations needs to be given to the officers and directors of the Barristers. You are the future of the Riverside County Bar Association, and it is incumbent upon us old timers to pass on to the next generation the very embodiment of the Riverside County Bar Association. Know from where we came, know where we are, and with that knowledge, you will lead this Bar Association into the future. Again, congratulations. Thank you.
President Choi, President Farouk, and each of the members of the RCBA and Barrister Boards, I congratulate you on your elections to the important offices that you now hold. Your elections indicate that your colleagues at the bar have confidence that you have both the skill and the dedication to preserve and enhance the organizations that you now serve. I am sure that you will prove that their confidence in you was well deserved. Over the course of the coming year, I hope that you will serve, explore, and lead. As officers and members of these boards, you will undoubtedly serve your associations, but I urge you to also look for ways to serve those that the associations exist to benefit: the bar, the justice system, and ultimately the members of the public served by that system. Consider how you and your association can best serve them. An explorer ventures into the unknown. In these days of the COVID-19 epidemic, so much that was once familiar is now strange, unfamiliar, and unknown. I encourage you to take this opportunity to explore the unknown and to discover new ways of doing things, whether it is a new way to meet your colleagues, a new way to work with opposing counsel, or a new way to present a trial. I hope that you will seek out new and better ways to practice this noble profession and to deliver justice to the public. Finally, I urge you to lead. Once you have found those new techniques, those better ways of practicing law, lead the rest of us into that future. Help us understand and embrace this new normal. I look forward to seeing where you will take us.
It's a great honor and privilege to be able to welcome you to the 2020 Riverside County Bar installation. Like you, I have a great love for the Riverside County Bar, an organization that has been around since 1894. An organization that, since we've been around, have done amazing things. Every board since I've been a member has done amazing things. With apologies to all the boards I'm not gonna mention because I could spend hours going over the great achievements, I'm gonna highlight a few achievements and a few boards. The 1994 board actually bought the Riverside County Bar building. Think about that. Think about the foresight that they had. As a result of their action, we get to meet up in the Gabbard Gallery once a month, fellowship, become a legal community, and be involved in each other's lives. How great was that board for thinking that through and seeing the vision of that? The 2001 and 2015 boards, I always think of them as charitable boards, which really goes to my love. The 2001 board gave us the elves. Every holiday season, we as a legal community get to give back to those who don't have as much to make sure that kids and families have a great season. We are raising the community to greater heights as a legal community. We are involving ourselves in the community. The 2015 board created the Riverside County Bar Foundation. What a great organization that is. Another charitable arm of the Riverside County Bar that has done so many great things in the 5 years since it's launched. The 2019 board, Jack Clark's board, well, they had to walk us through a pandemic. The earth literally came to a standstill, and that board, through their guidance and through their moral ethics, got us through that difficult time. And during that time, they were also able to give a facelift to the Riverside County Bar building. Great job, board. Now we're going to talk about the 2020 board. Sophia Choi coming in as our president, and I have to tell you, I am so excited about this board. I think this board can nail it better than all those other boards. I see potential in this board, but we're still in a pandemic and it's still hard. Join me, please. Let's rally around this board. Let's help them get to the heights that we all know they can get to, so that sometime in 2050 or 2100, someone can stand up at an installation and welcome other people and say, that 2020 board, let's talk about how great they were. Thank you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Virginia Blumenthal, a criminal defense attorney of 45 years in Riverside. I am thrilled and honored to be asked to say a few words and make a few comments to our incoming officers. First, I want to congratulate and thank the incoming officers for the Riverside County Bar Association and the Barristers Association. Both of these organizations are absolutely essential to our legal community, and especially in these uncharted waters of these pandemic times. I want to congratulate our incoming president, Sophia Choi, on her decision not to postpone the installation of officers. We need both of these organizations to proceed with their important leadership and their mission and stated purpose. We, the legal community, need them. It's their leadership that is so important, not the formal semi-gala of the swearing-in ceremony itself. I also want to congratulate our Bar Association for voting in a woman to serve as president this year, the 100th anniversary of women's right to vote. Congratulations to all of you, and thank you so very much for serving during these terrible and important times.
Hi, I'm Presiding Judge-elect John Monteroso, and I want to welcome and congratulate all the incoming members of the Riverside County Bar Association Board and the Barristers Board, including President Sophia Choi and Barristers President Gushia Farouk. We have faced unbelievable challenges in the last several months. once in a 100-year pandemic, as well as the economic turmoil that goes with it, has absolutely devastated us and caused us to have undue challenges, both in our professional lives and our personal lives. But this community has risen. We have worked together to ensure, to the extent possible, we can keep the wheels of justice turning. And I want to congratulate and thank everybody for your collegial spirit and your hard work and vigilance in getting us through this up to this point. And as we finish up this year and move into 2021, it's fast approaching. These challenges aren't going to be much easier. We're still going to have the health challenges and the economic challenges that go with it. So we must stay together as a community and keep working together to ensure that we can provide access to justice to all of those to the extent possible. As we do this, we also must keep in mind that we have lots of other areas we need to work on as a community. In particular, we need to demonstrate and need to keep working on making progress to be inclusive to all members of our community, to ensure that the courts provide equal access to everybody. And that means the courts, and that means the legal community as well. We all need to challenge ourselves to do better in that regard. We may think that we have been able to navigate the turmoil that we've seen across the country when it comes to racial justice, but we need to look inside ourselves as well, especially as a community, to see where can we do better, because everybody has room to improve. So I look forward to the new year. I look forward to working with all of you and getting through the challenges that we have in front of us together. Thanks and good luck.
Hey everybody, this is Judge Keene. I just wanted to take this opportunity to congratulate our incoming RCBA board. Over the years, I've gotten to know most of you pretty well. I've had the pleasure of serving on the In of Court board with Sophia over the last couple of years. Kelly, I've known you for a long time and had the pleasure of coaching mock trial with you over the last 4 years, looking forward to another season. Neil and Lori, I've known you since way back when you were in the public defender's office. Aaron, ever since you were a law student and before you came to the public defender's office. Elizabeth, I had the pleasure of serving on the same team as you last year in the In of Court. And so I feel fairly confident in saying that the RCBA is in great hands, and I want to congratulate all of you and wish you the best of luck in the coming year. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Jennifer Gerard, and I currently sit as a family law judge in Riverside County, downtown division. And I want to congratulate Sophia Choi as the incoming president for the RCBA. I'm quite proud of her, and the community is very lucky to have Sophia in that position. Sophia and I currently sit on the Leo A. Deegan Ends of Court together as board members, and she's a fantastic asset to our end, and I know she will be equally as fantastic in RCBA. I've known Sophia for some time, and her commitment to this community as well as to the other bar members is fantastic, and I think this is a great, great position for her to be in and to continue to help and continue her endeavors to be an asset to our community.